Hello and welcome to this Caspio training video series. My name is Ed Garcia, and in this series, I'll be showing you how to create a searchable online database. In this tutorial, we'll first focus on how to import data into the Caspio online database platform. Here's the homepage of Caspio Bridge and the list of all my apps I have created for different projects. First, let me show you a quick preview of what we're going to build today. In this example, I'm working with a contacts database. Here's my search interface, where end users can search by company name, first name, last name, and email. When user searches for contacts, it brings the reports page, in this case 25 records at a time. The user can view the details by clicking on the details link, of course. In this page, the end users can also update the status, specify a follow-up date, and add notes. So my contacts database first started in a Microsoft Excel file. So here's my Excel sheet with 200 plus records. Notice I have column headers, which will convert into database fields in Caspio and all the contact information down below. I can easily bring this over into Caspio and import the entire database to make it searchable online and manage in a central database in the cloud, just like the search interface that I just showed you. Before creating a search interface, first let me show you how to import data. And before importing your data in Caspio, double check to make sure that you have column names for each column. And these will again automatically convert into field names when I import the file into Caspio. Make sure that the first character is a letter, no special characters or space, but you can use underscores if you like. So I'll go ahead and go back to my Caspio account and show you how easy to import this data or any data in Caspio. All you have to do is click on Tools and click Import. I'll go ahead and locate for my file and click Next. It should only take a few seconds, and there it is. My file was uploaded successfully. So I'll go ahead and click Next again, and now I can choose which app I would like to import this data into. In this case, I would like to add it in my Contacts app. Now from this drop-down menu, I can choose to create new table by selecting Create New, or I can replace, append, or update design of an existing table. So if you have an existing table in Caspio, you can choose Replace to overwrite the existing data, or you can choose to append to add new data at the very end of the table. And lastly, update design means only new fields or columns are added to the table without importing the actual data. In this example, I'd like to create the table and name my table Contacts. And now I can click Next. And here's the last step. Basically, it's to verify all database fields and update as necessary so that data is imported exactly the way I want. Now, these are all the different data types in Caspio. Text255 for 255 characters. 64,000 for 64,000 characters, which is mostly used for notes and description fields. For any numeric fields, I have integer, number, and currency. Next, I have auto number, which will automatically generate a unique number for each record, incrementing by one. Date time for any fields. Date fields, yes, no, is mostly used for checkboxes, and of course, file for any files. If you choose password, Caspio will encrypt the data. And lastly, timestamp. So the idea here is to select the appropriate data type for each field. So I'll make sure that the date submitted field is set as date last time data type. And now that I'm done here, all I have to do is click import. If you're importing a large table, you don't have to wait on the screen. You can click close and move on to your next task while the data is importing behind the scenes. Okay, my import completed successfully. And Caspio also displays an alert in the messages area as a confirmation. So now going back to my Contacts app, I can click on Tables to view the data that I just imported. I can view it in a datasheet view, which allows me to work with my data just like an Excel spreadsheet. I can create a new record, delete, select specific records to delete, or use common data functions like find, replace, or filter based on any value in my table. At any time, I can click over to Table Design to add new fields or update the data type. And that concludes part one of this video series. Please continue on part two to see how to create a reports data page so that this data can be published online as a searchable database. For additional videos and training material, please visit howto.caspio.com. Thanks for watching.